university for the first time, the word leadership did not even exist. In fact, the buzzword at the time was management. And one of the most popular degrees that people used to hope for at the time, I'm talking about mid-80s, was MBA, Management of Business Administration. And most of the books that you get to read in that degree are related in some way or form to management. Maybe occasionally the word leadership was mentioned, but definitely not as it is now. The word leadership started gaining more ground, and with time it became the dominant one and the most, the sexiest one and the most attractive one. It's hardly, you know, possible that you open a newspaper and the word leadership is not there. And it spread to you, I mean, you name it, cooking leadership, cultural leadership, tribal leadership, ethnic leadership, creative leadership, authentic leadership, musical leadership, I mean, you name it. You name it, and they're all fine. I lost count how many kinds of leadership people talk about now. That's not the point. The point is the following. What I've also noticed, because I've spent my life in this, I spent at least, you know, 45, maybe even 50 years studying passionately this subject and going to the best schools, and I went to Princeton and Harvard, you know, and I have been CEO for 3 times, you know, of major organizations. So this is my life, you know, I put my life into this. So I'm very interested, and I've read, you know, hundreds and hundreds of books and literatures, and I've sat by the feet of the masters of, you know, thought leaders on this subject. So what I've noticed being with them and doing my personal thinking and research and observation about this is that the world management started moving into the negative space. So now I hear things like, when the people want to praise something, like, this is leadership talk, this is management talk, and what it means that, you know, it's a bad thing, it's a negative connotation. Managers talk like this, as if managers, I don't know, have a disease or something, right? Leaders do this, managers, second-class people, fools, idiots, whatever. Be a leader, not a manager. And I can't find anything in this domain to be more different than the truth. It's so unfair, and it's so wrong, and it's so ignorant. It's so ignorant to vilify management to this extent. You know, everybody, don't be a manager, be a leader. It's like you're swearing at somebody, calling them a manager. And suddenly now everybody, I mean, they don't even use that. They try to minimize the use of the term or the title manager in organizations. Team leader, champion, you know, whatever it is. Just stick the word leader next to it and it flies because it's a sexy word. So why is this so unfair? Because, my friends, leadership and management are completely different things. Completely different. Leadership is a role that has certain characteristics. Management is another role that has another characteristics. Can you have them together sometimes in the same person? Maybe. It's rare you can do that. But do you need them both? 100%. 100%. I'll tell you why. Leadership is about, you know, the classic terms that people use about change, for, or a better term, transformation. For me, I like the word evolution because it's change or transformation for a good purpose. That's what leadership is about. And evolution always wins because that's the key to survival and growth. And that's what companies, organizations, people, and societies, even biologically, that's what we're driven, adaptation and evolution. Management, from the other hand, is about process, is about equilibrium, is about stability, So leadership is about instability. It's about disruption. It's about changing the game. It's about doing things differently so that we can create a different reality. And this is absolutely important, 100% important, because you can't stay the same in a dynamic environment. You have to adapt minimum to stay alive. To grow, you need to adapt and evolve to become better through innovation, creativity, you name it. That's a long story. But you can't stay in that destabilizing, you know, inequilibrium phase all your life. You can't. It's unbearable because it's full of anxiety and stress. You need people to relax. You need to have a process that's steady. You can't just disrupt all the time. Imagine you go to a place and you're disrupting everything. Okay, so how can you function? Disrupt this process, disrupt that process, disrupt that process. So change. Okay, so every day, so we have to know the rules. You can't just keep changing the rules all the time in the name of evolution and disruption. It's not practical. You do it from time to time and when it's necessary and for a purpose. And that usually comes at a cost, serious cost, because destabilization is costly. People don't like that. Our tendency is to comfort, you know, to be sitting in our comfort zone, although this is a negative word now, but to be in a stable situation or equilibrium so that we can relax and we can think about the future. Otherwise, we'll be restless and all in a state of panic. So you need management, because management brings stability, management brings efficiency, management brings productivity, management brings equilibrium, management makes you sleep, you know, peacefully at home. If the people in the power company, they're not managing, not leading, managing the process where power is generated properly, you can't function at night. If the captain of an airplane, it is not exercising proper management, right? Following the rules and the processes by the book, literally by the book, to fly the plane, then people will die because let me disrupt all the rules of aviation. I'm going to try so and so. You can't try so and so when you have 500 people with you. You have to follow the book, the manual. Now, is that fixed? No, it should not be fixed. It should be modified, adapted, evolved, changed all the time. But it has to be done wisely. And from time to time, then you go back to stability. You can't just keep people, you know, put people in a blender and just shake them all the time. It doesn't work like this. Bottom line, there's no good or bad. We need both. We need brilliant leaders and we need absolutely brilliant managers. And find yourself, get to know yourself and see who you are. If you are great in exercising leadership, you know, promoting change, disruption, mobilizing people through change and confusion and the whole thing so that you can create a better reality, good for you. If you can't do that, you're more of the stable process type, right? Equilibrium, stability, predictability. Do that. We need both. Find out who you are and do that. And most importantly, respect both people, because we need both and both roles need to be respected.